make sure it can enter his house. This is a simple, freshly built, adorable baby Pwnagotchi. And this is a Pwnagotchi. I'm gonna be showing you what it's capable of and how you could take your baby Gotchi to a whole new level with what I call Project Pwnag0dchi. But first, disclaimer. Okay, step 0 and pretty much the only prerequisite here is to be running the base Pwnag0dchi image by jayofelony on your device. Link in the description. Now, here on the right, I have my Gotchi SSH terminal. And on the left, my Gotchi's web UI. I'm gonna put the SSH terminal aside for a minute and restart my Gotchi in auto mode so you can see all the Project Pwnag0dchi customizations in action. This project essentially consists of modified variants of custom plugins to maximize the amount of useful information on screen, especially considering the tiny real estate on your tiny device. Alright, now that my Gotchi is in auto mode and you can see some activity here, let's talk about the custom plugins. But before that, here's the basics without the custom plugins. This is the channel the Gotchi is currently operating on. The number of access points on the current channel. The total number of access points on all channels. The Bluetooth connection status. The amount of time your Gotchi has been up for. This may be unreliable if you don't have a battery module connected. The Gotchi's name. The Gotchi's face that changes according to the current activity. The number of handshakes captured in the current session, total number of handshakes captured in the Gotchi's entire lifetime, the current mode the Gotchi's running on, and the live activity feed. Now, I know what you're thinking. What about these? Pwnag0dchi, dog. Let's walk through all the custom plugins here. Better QuickDick automatically runs an offline dictionary attack on the Gotchi itself as soon as a valid handshake is captured. Display password automatically puts the latest successfully cracked password on the screen with the SSID of the access point. Enable ASSOC and enable deauth allow you to easily set the aggressiveness of your Gotchi without restarting the Pwnag0dchi service. With these two simple switches, you can enable and disable association and deauthentication attacks. As you can see, these take effect pretty much instantly, and I've added convenient little indicators to be displayed on screen for the attack or attacks you have enabled. Next, EXP adds levels in an XP bar that increase as your Gotchi collects handshakes over time. Handshakes-dl lets you easily download captured handshakes from the web UI in pcap format for, let's say, further analysis. Here's the list of captured handshakes, and clicking one instantly downloads it to my computer or Bluetooth connected phone. Next, internet connection simply adds an indicator to the screen that shows whether your Gotchi is connected to the internet. IPDisplay shows the interface's IP address to help with SSH. Currently, it's showing me my web UI's address since my Gotchi is connected to my computer, but this IP would change if I'm connected via my phone though. Memtemp-plus displays the real-time hardware stats like CPU usage and temperature so you could monitor them. Tweak view allows you to modify all on-screen elements in terms of fonts, sizes, positions, etc. in real-time without having to restart the Pwnag0dchi service. All you would need to do is make any changes here, click Update View, and your changes would be applied to the screen immediately. These values you're seeing are going to be important, and I'll talk about this during the installation tutorial. Coming back to the plugins again, WebCFG allows you to play with the Pwnag0dchi settings via the web UI. I'll talk about this later too. Now, wpa-sec is pretty cool. Whenever your Gotchi has internet access, this plugin will automatically upload captured handshakes to the wpa-sec online tracking service. This service is completely free and runs dictionary attacks with 20 to 30 large word lists against each handshake. And lastly, wpa-sec-list fetches any successfully cracked handshakes from the previous wpa-sec plugin and then puts them in a neat alphabetically sorted list. Here's the latest SSID and password, and the same is displayed on my Pwnagotchi. Now that you know what all these plugins do, cue the epic installation guide music. Okay, step 1. Get yourself to the Project Pwnagotchi GitHub page. You can find a full list of features and tips here, or even follow my guide to building a Pwnagotchi from scratch. Anyway, download or clone, gotta hit the star first. Yeah, download or clone, and then extract its contents. Next, connect your Pwnagotchi to your computer and fire up FileZilla. I'm deleting the directories we won't be needing for the installation process to keep things a little simpler. Much better. We're only going to need these two directories for the installation. One contains the config files, and the other contains all custom plugins. Now, let's connect to the Pwnagotchi to transfer these downloaded files onto it. Filling in my Gotchi's IP, username, and password. Fun fact, you would think the port should be 21, since that's what the FTP service uses, but we're going to be using port 22 for SFTP here, secure FTP. Don't forget to change the protocol to SFTP here, and hit connect. This should take a few seconds. When the connection's successful, you'll see the directory listing successful status. You're now ready to drop files into your Pwnagotchi. Let's do the plugins first. Navigate to the user, local, share, Pwnagotchi, custom plugins directory. Then select all the downloaded plugins from the left side, which is your computer, and drag them to the right side. This is going to take a while. Should I roll the sponsored segment here? What if there's not enough time? Fuck it. PCBWay has been around for a literal... Anyway, if you get a prompt to overwrite files, go ahead and overwrite them. I'm not going to be doing that here since I already have them. It's going to ask me that for each file, so I'll skip the whole queue, but you should be overwriting though. Alright, plugins are done. Next, the config files. Navigate to the etc Pwnagotchi directory. And maybe make a backup of your config.toml file before proceeding if you would like. This tweak view file contains my tweak view plugins config from earlier in the video. Same drill, select from left, drag to right, overwrite, and you're done. You can now terminate the SFTP connection and quit FileZilla. Now, to correctly apply the plugins and configs, reboot your Pwnagotchi. This will take a while, so here's that sponsored content. PCBWay has been around for a literal decade. Look at the amount of granular control you have while placing custom PCB orders. And if you're not a PCB guy, watch how easy it is for me to add a Pwnagotchi case design to PCBWay's 3D printing service. Ooh, look at that Game Boy purple. The range of services is ridiculous. These guys even cover CNC machining. Also, since it's their 10th year anniversary, PCBWay has some cool exclusive events with coupons and lucky draws that could win you items from their modules page. Go check them out from the link in the description. Okay, my Gotchi seems to be up again from that reboot, so I'll SSH into it. Confirm that the config files have been transferred correctly. and all the plugins as well. At this point, you're almost done. Just need to make some minor changes to the config.toml file. If you're not comfortable playing around with the SSH terminal, don't worry about it. I'll talk about that in a minute. First, you're gonna need to change this SSID value here to your home network's SSID to whitelisted. This tells the Pwnagotchi to not constantly attack your home Wi-Fi. Next, do the same for grid exclude. Okay, one final step. If you want to use the wpa-sec plugin to automatically upload handshakes online and crack them, you're gonna need an API key. Don't worry though, it takes less than a minute and is completely free. All you gotta do is head over to this URL. Your key field should be empty here. So click Get Key, enter your email address, swear that you're not a product of Boston Dynamics, and hit Get Private Key. That's it. You'll be emailed an API key within a few seconds, which you can now put here. Once you've made all changes, press Ctrl and S on your keyboard to save this config file. You'll see this message at the bottom confirming your save. Then press Ctrl X to exit the editor. Restart the Pwnagotchi service, and you now have the dopest Pwnagotchi in the galaxy. If you don't like messing around with the SSH terminal, you can apply the same configurations using the webcfg plugin. As you can see here, each line from the config.toml file is easily editable via the web UI using the webcfg plugin. You can make any changes you'd like here. And once you're done, scroll to the top and hit save and restart. This will restart the Pwnagotchi service to apply all your settings. Also, to confirm if you've set up your wpa-sec API key correctly, you can click on the wpa-sec plugin and then see if your API key automatically appears at the top. If you've set it up correctly, you should now have access to the MyNets page, which will list all valid uploaded handshakes and their cracking statuses. Okay, you're now on Project Pwnagotchi. If you're facing problems with the project, leave a comment or open up a GitHub issue so I could help. Also, let me know what Pwnagotchi stuff you'd like to see next, and don't forget to follow ShurikenHacks on Instagram for a lot more Pwnagotchi content I don't post on YouTube. Anyway, like and subscribe for more stuff. Until then, make Shuriken. Sure